festival state, the Adelaide Fringe is in full swing.
This year we're doing Peter Coombs show, we're doing Fix the Fence with Sticky Tape. It's singing and dancing.
I honestly love the Fringe because I love that you can see all these different shows with different people exposing their talents, and also I love the rides.
It's really exciting because I've only done one other live show recently, and it was very small.
For performers like these guys, this festival is particularly special.
Many artists haven't even performed since Adelaide Fringe 2020. This is their first time back on stage.
It was tough because a lot of shows were cancelled, people weren't making enough money to what they usually are, and a lot of them were going out of business, and that was really sad for them.
It's not just here in Adelaide that the arts are making a comeback.
Well, moving on from online musicals to normal musicals on stage, I recently got a part in Hairspray, and I'm one of the nicest kids in town. Woo! And this is my brother who also got into Hairspray. Good morning, BTS!
As you might be able to tell, Ben is a bit of a musical theatre fan, so he's pretty excited to see Australia host big international shows again.
Oh yeah, we did see a show recently. What was it called again? It was called Away From... Oh wait, hold on. Yeah, Come From Away. It was really good and we were the first people to see it reopening worldwide. And the producers from America came here to thank us, great job, Melbourne, you kept going, and you were the first people to open globally.
But of course, things aren't quite the same as pre-COVID.
We had to wear a mask when we went into the theatre, and then we had to be socially distant, so if one person was sitting here, there'd be a seat in between, and then another person would be sitting there.
Here at the Fringe, organisers have tried to make things a bit more COVID safe, with more outdoor shows and lots of these around the place.
I think it's different because there's a lot of COVID check-ins and hand sanitizers everywhere and less people are coming.
Of course, holding a big event like this in the middle of a pandemic is a risk. And as we've seen quite a few times now, things can change quickly when it comes to COVID. A lot of people around the world are watching Australia to see if we can safely pull off our big arts comeback, while we all wait for the world to get back to normal.
Probably hoping for next year, more people will come. Yeah, because I love performing and everything.
I'm hoping that there's less restrictions and that we can get more people to come to shows and that it's all back to normal, hopefully.
I'm kind of hoping that COVID kind of goes away so that we can do more live performances, because it's been a bit hard for especially professional artists because it's now all online.
Hopefully this year we can all get back to doing what we love.